Welcome to the United Arab Emirates, a country with a hot climate, a coastline that stretches for more than 650 kilometres, and some of the biggest and best water sports activities on the planet. At its centre, Dubai, one of the most visited cities in the world. It's home to the country's largest natural harbour, as well as many miles of golden beaches. And as its backdrop, a vibrant city, a vast skyline, and some of the world's most ambitious architecture. Within the popular holiday resort of Mina Seyahi lies the Dubai International Marine Club, whose busy team of experts and enthusiasts showcase a year-round programme of international water sports events, including the XCAT World Series, organised by the World Professional Powerboat Association alongside the UIM. And WPPA General Secretary Sid Bensala is looking forward to an exciting second season of XCAT racing.
This year we have four races, two in Dubai, two in Abu Dhabi, and for the first time will be a world championship at the end of the season, three events here in UAE, with a very good concept for 2011 to go global under the UIM umbrella. We have so far between 13 to 14 nationalities right now, but I can tell you that this sport is growing and is going on the right track. For this first heat in Dubai, we have 21 official entries, and people asking us why you have so many teams and new boats. And I mean, it's successful because it's very simple and straightforward. We keep the budget very, very tight without allowing any kind of fancy, not needed technology or accessories. There is not much that you can introduce from the electronic point of view, the design point of view, and things like that. It comes really to the manpower, to the one behind the wheel and behind the throttle. Because I can tell you, when you see a race now, it's very hard to predict who will cross the finishing line first. You know, it's a battle, it's a war, and it's a close combat, and it's a fight all the way to the last minute, and everything, anything can happen. So, and this is the beauty and this is the charm of the sport.
In 2009, the inaugural XCAT World Series went right down to the wire and was eventually won by Italian boat La Vida Loca. Throttleman Giovanni Carpentella helping the team to victory in the face of some stiff competition. So how does he rate the championship?
There is a lot of nation, a lot of boats. The fighting is very close. Last year also we have four races and four different wins and four different second place also. So every race is different than the other one, and everybody can win here. This year, unfortunately, I don't have my usual partner, Christian. So this year we optimized to make a school for the new drivers coming. So in four races, I have three new drivers, and they don't have a race. I don't try to defend the title.
One of those best placed to put together a serious title bid is local team Fazza, the current Class 1 world champions. But how does racing in XCATs compare?
It's a different challenge. Because everyone can compete in this category. You see a lot of good drivers here, young, and the engines are almost all the same. There comes the talent of the right setup, the right prop, what condition you're going to use this prop for the rough, smooth. So it plays a big factor when you're in Class 1 to jump to Class 3. We have a new boat that we didn't test that much. It's a bit a wider tunnel boat, same length. But we have to do a lot of testing to get this boat to a right setup. We didn't have a lot of chance to do that. But today we got an idea about the boat, what we should do. Hopefully tomorrow is a different day, and it's going to be, I think, rougher tomorrow. So it should be for a rough setup, hopefully. It's not going to be easy, but we're going to really push for it.
Also returning for a second season is British team Kingfisher. Despite running an outdated boat in 2009, they were consistent frontrunners, and now they're back with a brand new machine.
It was built by Chris Bastidge Racing. It's made of e-glass and Kevlar and high-density foam. It's a very light boat. We ran it in Italy in the World Championships and came second. So we're quite sort of positive with it, really. But this is more competitive than the 6-litre World Championships. We've altered the running surface. We've allowed the boat to rock back more because they run us in flatter waters here. So it allows us to do that, whereas you can't do that if it's rough. If we've got our setup right and we make the right prop choice, then you know that'll be good. It's a new course today. We haven't run this course before, so it's new for everyone.
Having made their debut in the final race of 2009, Sweden's Westerland Racing are about to embark on a full campaign. Clearly, the series made a positive impact.
Yeah, we loved it. That's why we're back. They're very good competitors, a lot of boats, of course, and it's probably the best drivers in the world, so it's a very exciting series, and they're fast boats, and we enjoy it. We are used to really rough conditions in Sweden. We like it when it's rough, so it's more fun to race when it's rough. It's more competitive. A lot of people can go fast when it's flat water, but when it starts to get rough, it's kind of challenge you more, so we like that.
One of the new teams for 2010 is Lux Media Offshore, throttled by Frenchman Michel Carcenti and steered by the USA's Mike Siebold.
The gentleman I'm driving with is Michel Carcenti, and he lives here in Dubai. And he called me up about 6-8 months ago, and he said, hey, they have this XCAT series over here that's really popular, very competitive. And he goes, if I build a boat, you want to race with me? I said, sure. And I knew about the class somewhat because Gary Blue from Miami, I mean, he's been racing over here for a few years and he's a good friend of mine. And he told me about it, that it's very competitive. And that's what I want to do. I want to get in a class that's competitive. And I think this is probably one of the biggest offshore classes there are right now with the amount of competitors that are in it. We're going to be a little new getting into the sport. I mean, we're not looking to come out here and set any kind of records right now, but we just want to get some seat time together. But overall, I think the boat's showing some good numbers. It feels good. The setup in this class is everything. And your propellers, your weight, I mean, it's so critical with the horsepower you have. You really have to be dialed in to be very competitive in it.
As with any form of motor-driven high-speed sport, offshore powerboat racing carries an element of risk. But thanks to the continued work of the technical teams at the WPPA and the UIM, safety standards have never been higher. Technical Director Patrick Heslop tells us about the latest developments.
The main improvement is safety for the pilots. I mean, that's our number one focus. The rules have changed. The canopies are much stronger now. They've got all integral roll bars in them. They've been beefed up. They have water deflectors front and back. The bulkheads are much stronger now. We're just trying to protect the pilots much more.
The nature of racing at high speed over big waves means that very occasionally boats can capsize. It's an eventuality that the rescue crew and the teams themselves are trained to overcome.
Yeah, this is the mandatory dunk test we're doing. Because the pilots of the powerboats, they have to have these special skills to get out the boat in the shortest time frame. Because it's a very difficult situation when you're upside down, your nose gets full of water, the visibility is very bad, and then you need to have this complete sequence in your head, know it by heart, extricate yourself. They have to do it at least twice after a whole sequence of practice. One with air, where they can take their air themselves, breathe and orient themselves in order for them to find the access, open the hatch, unbuckle and then get out themselves with air supply. And then they have to do it without the air supply. Should they not find their air immediately, they know the skills by heart and get immediately under the boat and get out in the same sequence.
And so it was time for the boats to head out to sea for the first qualifying session of the year. In total, a very healthy field of 21 boats from all over the world were about to race against the clock. The team with the fastest time lap would start the race from pole. However, it wasn't exactly the perfect start to the season for Fazza's second team in boat 33.
During the practice, we had an engine problem, and the guys now are trying to replace the engine, and we'll see if we can catch the pole position. If not, we will be in the last, and we'll try our best to push hard and to reach the first buoy.
After narrowly missing out on the title at the end of last season, Qatar team were back at the sharp end, qualifying third fastest. Also impressing was the Westerland Racing team from Sweden, second fastest in only their second XCAT event. But the team to beat was Faza, taking pole position for the first race of the season.
Really, I am happy about today because yesterday I am work hard. Don't forget, this is a new boat. The first time I tested yesterday, and I saw the boat is fast, but is not stable. I play with the weight yesterday night, and today is absolutely different, our boat. I am happy about what I see in the water.
We're all set then for round one of the XCAT World Series. Join us after the break for race action.